Well, presently, as you know, we're in the process of putting the team together. The selection of the players had to go in a couple of days ago, as you may appreciate, because we have to secure airline tickets, etc. And by early next week, I should be able to announce the selection. We're just waiting on seeing how the weekend goes, etc. But the names have been submitted already.
It's not, it has been mentioned that this team in particular has a tremendous record since you've taken over the helm of the team. If we look back at the records, interestingly, not since they defeated Haiti in the 2013 CONCACAF World Cup has this team been defeated in a competitive fixture in regulation time. What do you have to say about something like this?
Well, first and foremost, I am not a miracle worker. It's an achievement based on the back of a very strong staff, and most importantly, players that are committed to buying into what we have been trying to do. And we have been striving to try and create some sort of consistency in what we do. But you must be also aware that in international football, it is very, very hard to maintain consistency, because the team is absent from you for such long periods. So it is even a little bit more surprising to me, and a credit to the players that they have kept their focus, kept the competition high within the squad for selection, and when they step on the field, do everything that is in their efforts possible to come away with a result.
Of course, we understand that the main focus over the next couple of weeks will be the two upcoming World Cup qualifiers. But yesterday, CONCACAF also announced the date and venue for the Copa America playoff in January 8. Can you comment on this for us?
It took me by surprise, in the sense that we've been waiting for this announcement for a long time, and for them to make a decision to play on a non-FIFA date puts us in a very difficult situation, because all the clubs are now in a position to not release players to you, whether they are playing now or not. I have made a request to the local leagues to give us a preparation time, so in which to, you know, they can, if they can, cut off the league and give us at least 10 days to prepare, and then I will after these two games I will address the clubs directly and try and see if I can secure the release of the players, because the team is going to be largely based on those players that are made available to me, and right now I can't answer that question.
And then finally, from me, before we proceed, based on your understanding, can you give us an update on Kenwyne Jones?
No, Kenwyne is back in training. The club has a very important game. Well, they have a game on Saturday, but they have a very important game on Tuesday, which they would more than likely play him in the Tuesday game. Now, I'm guessing, I'm not the club manager, but the game on Tuesday is a big game for them. I'll guess they will be cautious on the Saturday game, play him in the Tuesday game and play him in the next Saturday game.
You spoke earlier about the commitment of the players and them buying into your plan. How do you see this overall project being undertaken by the TTFA in terms of marketing and getting the word out there, tying in with what you're trying to accomplish with the team?
Yes, of course, because if you look at any organization, the marketing team behind the team, so to speak, is extremely important. But it's not just about the senior team, it's the marketing of the international football family, which is the women's teams and the youth teams. I think it's extremely important to create that identity, and hopefully we can do what is necessary on the field, knowing our public, that would keep generating the interest and also bringing new fans, because we have a lot of young players that a lot of young people that are not familiar with the national team program.